Hola amigas y amigos de primer grado, Maestra Peterson aquí con ustedes otra vez. And together we're going to do another art lesson. For this art lesson today, I chose something very, very interesting because this week you're also learning a lot about geometric shapes, figuras geométricas en matemáticas. So I wanted to share with you this art by an artist called Pierre Mondrian. That is all about what you're learning in math this week. Let me show you the art right away. Very cool, huh? Okay, so that's what we're gonna be looking at today. But first, let's remember the steps that I'd like you to follow to continue working with this art. So, la primera cosa que vamos a hacer, the first thing we're going to do, we're going to describe it. Vamos a describir el arte. ¿Qué ven ustedes? What do you see? What does it look like to you? Okay? And then la segunda cosa, ¿cómo se sienten? ¿Y por qué? You're going to tell somebody next to you how you feel and why do you think you feel that way when you look at that art. Y finalmente, finally, número tres, vamos a recrear el arte. We're going to recreate it in our own way. So let's look at the art again. It's always good to pause the video so you can take a good look at it. Primero, vamos a describir. ¿Qué ven ustedes? What do you see here? Bien, número dos. The second thing, you're going to tell somebody how you feel and why. Digan a alguien cómo se sienten y por qué. Una buena hora para pausar el video. It's a good time to pause the video. Y finalmente, mi parte favorita, my favorite part, we're going to recreate it, okay? To recreate this piece of art by Pierre Mondrian, you can use crayons, you can use markers, you can use blocks, you can use objects around the house to stack them up. Ustedes pueden usar crayolas, plastilina, bloques o objetos que tienen en sus casas para hacer las formas que están aquí. Okay? This should be really, really fun to recreate. Remember, there are no wrong ways. Your own way is your own art. I'm just showing you a point of inspiration, something that you can start from. Okay, and before I go, I'd like to share with you what another artist used as inspiration to create his own art. This artist made a video and it was inspired by one of the paintings by Pierre Mondrian. The painting was this one. You see this painting? A little, my paper is not super flat. So this is the painting. And now I'm going to show you the video of what this artist thought. Like when he looked at the painting, he's like, oh, this looks like something else. Let me see what I can do with it. So I'm going to share with you now. He created, adios. He created this little video based on a painting by Pierre Mondrian that I'd like you to watch with me right now. It's really short, so we'll watch it together. So that's what the artist thought of when he looked at this painting. he imagined as a really busy city, busy streets with buses and cars and people. And I thought that was very cool how he used one piece of art that already existed and made a completely new thing inspired by the first art. I hope you guys enjoyed that little video and that you have fun doing this activity with lots of figuras geométricas, lots of geometric shapes. When you are done, please take a picture and send it to your teacher. Until next time.